Good morning. So we're gonna start in 1 minute. Thank you for coming. Good morning, Julia. Good morning, Maria. Okay. All right, it's 6 o'clock, so let's get started. Find our way into a seated position, sitting tall, supremely still. Close the eyes, begin the journey inward. Nothing to do, nothing to seek. Everything we need is already within. Let's begin with the sound of Om three times to call divine attention to the self. Imagine you are everywhere. Your mind on God alone. Rest your mind in God alone. This there is no doubt. May all beings everywhere be happy and free from suffering and enjoy this practice through our senses. I'll chant the mantra for purification once, and if you know it, you can chant along with me, and if you don't worry about it, just let us know. You derive all the benefits as though you were chanting. Om Pavitraha Pavitra Vasava Vashtanga Tokiwa Yaha Smarit Pandrikam Sabahya Pihantra Hatschihi. Come to standing now. So we're going to start off with some exercises to prepare the body for practice and to help to purify the body as well. Make it put it into the most sublime as possible in order to allow the soul inside to flourish. So standing with our feet about hip width apart, inhale, raise your arms up, exhale, down, and up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, one more, up, down. Inhale, straight up, down, pull. And extend forward, retract. Breathing deeply, exhaling deeply on each action. Good. And now we're going to do arm swings. Chest, squeeze tightly, throw the arms back. With the exhales, we're oxygenating the blood and we're bringing heat into the body. One more each side and release. Now the arms swing over the head, swing the body down. Through the mouth on these, on the downswing. One more. Just remain down, allow the body to just stop bouncing around. And then roll your way back up, leading to the upper back. The head is the last thing that comes up. Next, we're going to do squats. Come all the way down to the ground. If it's too hard on the knees, you can stop halfway down. Move according to your condition. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, pull down. Two more. And one. Good. We're going to come up again. Elbows out to the side. Twist from side to side. Again, exhale as you complete the twist on each side. And conclude. The next one is a squat and done in four parts. As you inhale, we sweep the arms up. Exhale, squat. Inhale, straight back up with the arms. Exhale, swing down. And let's go. Up, down, up, down. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. In, exhale, inhale, 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 exhale, one more, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Good. Now the arms come right out in front. This is the starting position. Exhale, inhale, circle around. Exhale, pull back and punch right forward again. Let's begin. Two more. Good, now drop the arms by the sides. It's the exact same, but it's a circle and a quarter. So inhale, exhale, and just swing the arms right down to start again. Exercise, their side bends. Inhale, sweep the left arm up. Exhale to the right. Inhale, right arm comes up and bend to the left. And let's continue. Try to bend as much as you can without wrinkling the underside of the body. Push the hips and ribs out to the opposite side that you're twisting or bending. Good. Next one is the same thing except we're holding on the bend. So it goes inhale, left arm up. Hold the breath as you lean to the right. And come back on the exhale, inhale, right arm up. Hold the breath, go to the left. And release on the exhale. And let's continue. Lose yourself in the sensations. Do everything with mindfulness, deliberateness, and reverence. more on each side. And conclude. So now let's come onto the hands and knees. Knees underneath the hips, hands underneath the shoulders, cat-cow. Inhale, arch the back. Imagine trying to stretch the skin of the belly. Exhale, round the back. Imagine trying to stretch the skin of the back. Inhale again. Exhale. Feel the shoulder blades falling away from one another on the exhale. Inhale. Heart opens up, comes forward. Exhale, imagine trying to push it up between the shoulder blades. Inhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, attune to the sensations along the spine, exhale, inhale, exhale, and last one, inhale, exhale. Now from here, we're coming down into child's pose. Forehead down, breathe in, breathe out. On the next exercise, I'll just demonstrate. Inhale, come into high cat. Exhale, drop the hips between the hands. Pull the shoulders back, the chest forward. Inhale, back into high cat. Exhale, pull all the way back into child's pose, sink back on the heels. Let's begin. Inhale, exhale, cobra, inhale, high cat, baby pose, and again, inhale, exhale, inhale, and back, inhale, exhale, chest forward, shoulders back, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Lose yourself in sensations. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. One last time. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Take pause in child's pose, breathe in, and breathe out. Next exercise is almost the same, except we hold on the cobra. So inhale, start to slide forward onto the belly. And then as you're in cobra, hold it for a few seconds. Exhale, all the way back. And do it with me now. Come forward, pull with your hands. Hold as you stay in cobra. Hold the breath and exhale back. Inhale forward. Glide on the belly. Raise the chest. Exhale back. Inhale. Come into cobra another way if you need to. Modify according to your condition. Exhale. So just demonstrate quickly so we can come up a little bit more, a little higher. And then land your hips in the cobra on the ground as you come cobra. And back down. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Do the version that is your body. Inhale.
one more. Inhale.
Exhale.
Take again, breathe in. And breathe out.
Come onto the belly and flip over onto your back. Now we're going to do some tucks. Just first though, take a deep breath in. Exhale, remove all fatigue. Okay, now on the inhale, extend the arch and legs as much as you can. And hold an exhale, come into a tuck. Thighs into the knees, forehead to the knees. Inhale, straight back out. Extend. And exhale. Squeeze yourself as small as possible. Inhale, reach out. Elongate. Push out through the heels and base the toes. Exhale. Pull it all in. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Completely empty your lungs. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Inhale. Exhale. And release. Breathe in. Breathe out. Inhale, arms and legs out again. Hold the breath and tuck. Exhale. Inhale. Stretch. Hold the breath and tuck. Exhale. Inhale. Tuck. Hold the breath. Exhale. Inhale, reach out. Hold the breath and tuck. Exhale. Inhale. Hold and tuck. Exhale. Inhale. And tuck. Exhale. Inhale. Tuck. Exhale. One last time. Inhale. Reach out. And tuck. Exhale. Again, just relax. Breathe in. Imagine you're fainting. Exhale. Allow everything to go loose. Let's swing your legs up. Press into the arms, lift the feet, and then that gives you momentum to come right up into standing position. Okay, so we'll continue with the sun salutations. First, just shake out the wrists a few times, swing them from side to side, move the fingers very fast, and up and down. Good. Just a few head rolls. Feel as though the head were very heavy, and then switch directions. Now let's make our way to the top of the mat. Join the hands again at the heart center. And imagine that all the actions you're doing and the benefits you derive from them are being transmitted to all beings everywhere. Do the practice. Because it is a divine duty to all beings. Let's move together as one to stay in that collective mind. Arms up over the head. Come down. Bend your knees if you need to bring your chest onto your thighs and head down, hands flat on the ground. Right foot back into a ledge. Drop down to the seat. Come into high plank. Immediately lower it down. Turn your fingers out a little bit. Elbows close to the body, hugging the sides of the body. Inhale, pull with your hands, pull the body right through into cobra, arch the back, head towards the seat. And roll over the toes back into downward facing dog. Right foot now steps forward to the hands, if it didn't make it there, it's difficult, lower the left knee and move the right foot forward with the right hand. Feet together, chest on the sides, Uttanasana again. Bring the heads back home.
Inhale, reach up.
Watch the body moving in your mind gracefully.
And then this will transpire in your practice.
Left foot back into a lunge,
into a plank. Lower down, knees, chest and chin.
And glide through between the arms. Watch the body moving like you're the witness.
Roll over the toes back into downward facing dog. Left foot steps forward.
And then feet together, Uttanasana.
Body against the legs. Come all the way up to standing.
Return home.
Reach up and back.
Go down. Remember, if you see the body moving with grace in your imagination, chances are, if you try it with your body, you move the body, it will move in the same way as you see it in your mind. Lower down, knees, chest, and chin. Glide forward into cobra. And then back.
Offer up the best that you can. Right foot forward.
Feet together, Uttanasana, fold the body in half. Come all the way up to standing, stretch the front of the body. Return home.
Left side again,
up. Go down.
Left foot back into a lunge.
Into a plank.
And down we go.
Knees, chest, and chin. Glide between the arms. Coming up into cobra. And back into downward facing dog.
Left foot steps
front. Right foot joins.
Press the body into legs, head down.
Come all the way up, standing salute. Hands back to the heart.
Right side again.
Go down.
Lose yourself in the sensations. Right foot back. Don't worry too much about the breath. Just move the body
in a way that seems to allow the breath to remain steady and constant in its rhythm.
Roll over the toes back into downward facing dog. Right foot forward. And then,
if you do this, the breath will lend some fluidity to the movements. Come all the way up. Hands back to the heart.
Left side.
Go down gracefully.
Left foot back.
Feel as though you're doing a dance.
All the movements
melting into one another. Transitions are smooth. And take the seat up and back, downward facing dog.
Left foot steps forward to the hands.
Drop the seat right down.
Uttanasana, body into the legs.
Come up to standing. Return home.
We'll do one more cycle. Arms up.
Go down.
Right foot back into a lunge.
Following up, high plank. Lower down, knees, chest, and chin. Glide forward and up. Lose yourself again
in the sensations. Right foot steps forward to the hands.
Feet together, chest on the sides, and push the legs back a little bit more. Come all the way up to standing. And that's back to the heart.
Left side, conclude.
Go down.
Left foot back into a lunge.
Into a plank.
Lower knees, chest, and chin.
Glide right through between the arms into cobra. And take it back into downward facing dog.
Left foot steps front.
Right foot joins. Bow to the legs. Come up to standing. Hands back to the heart. Take a moment. Take pause. Then deeply. Exhale. Remove all fatigue. Remove all attachments to the results. And release the arms. So we're going to do something now, a sequence called a warrior sequence. So it's a sequence of warrior poses. Imagine again that you're in the body of a warrior and just embody all the characteristics of power and courage and everything that we associate with heroes like that. Take a deep breath in and exhale, fold down over the legs.
Just take a moment to release the backs of the legs, press into your chest, into your thighs, press your hands into the backs of the legs, just on the calf muscles, and then push back against the legs of the body. Doesn't matter if you can't get your legs to straighten all the way, just try to keep your chest with your thighs. Now imagine you're trying to get the chest beyond the knees, and the top of the head to eventually come right on the top of the feet. Be very flexible, legs are straight, and the forehead is resting against the shin, so the nose is between the legs. Coming back up, plant the hands and step the right foot back. Back foot is flat, toes turned in outwards a little bit. And then inhale, come all the way up into Virabhadrasana 1, Warrior 1. Take the arms up, you can either have the hands apart or together like the tip of a sword. Bring the head back, look up, and just express complete surrender and devotion in this dance. The lower back, rise tall. Moving into Warrior 2, open up to the right, shoulders down. If you have the flexibility, open up the stance a little bit more. Press into the feet as though you're trying to stretch them out between the feet. Exalted Warrior, the right hand comes and presses into the back leg. Left arm over the head. Make sure that the legs don't change. The front leg is still in a right angle. Knee over the heel. Shoulders back, chest high. Inhale back into Warrior 2. Straighten out the front leg. And then drop the hands down. Turn the chest forward. And we want to adjust the feet now. So take the right foot in a little bit. Out to the right. And make sure that the back heel can be flat on the ground. So if you need to move it closer, then do so. Now you want to square off the hips so that the chest and the hips are facing are square. Pull the hands down, interlace the hands behind the back, lift the chest, bring the head back. Now from here we're coming into first pyramid pose. So as you come down, make sure the left hip doesn't come forward. Keep the hips square, bend your front knee if you need to, so you can rest your chest on the thigh. Inhale, pull the left hip back. Exhale, glide your body further down the leg. Arms are back behind the seat. Pull the arms back. Each time you inhale, pull the left hip back. Exhale, press more weight into the leg with your body. Inhale, come up halfway. Bend the front knee. And then just slip your body to the right so that you can come on the inside of the leg. Maybe you can get, those who are more flexible, the head down to the ground, slide your right foot back further so that you flatten out a little bit, you get lower to the ground. Getting ready to come back, pull hands back on the back, come up halfway, and then plant your hands down on the ground. I'm going to switch so that you don't have to switch. I'm doing it so you can see me. So your feet are parallel to one of the edges of your feet and your hands are between the feet. Bring your hands to the hips and come all the way up. Now from here, we're moving into a back bend. So take the hands around to the seat, pull down on the seat, press the hips forward so that your knees are over the toes. Inhale, roll the thighs outwards, exhale. Keep pushing into the seat and down in the same motion, so an inward and downward motion. Lift the chest, bring the head back. Inhale, coming back up. Good. Exhale, turn to the front again. And now we're on the other foot. So we take the back foot, slide it out a little bit more so you can square the hips. Long lunge, Warrior One. Reach the arms up. Take the gaze up.
embody fierceness, devotion. Open up to the side for warrior two. Sink into the hips a little bit, shoulders down, gaze over the front hand. Be still in the pose. Exalted warrior. Left hand to the back leg, right arm up. Make sure as you come back with the arm, you're lifting your chest up and try to take all the folds out of the side body. Back to warrior two. Good. Now from here, we're going to press into the front knee if you need to. Bring the back foot back in and then turn forward. Hips and shoulders square, the back toes move in a little bit of a steeper angle. Take the hands behind the back, pull the hands down, inhale, lift the chest, bring the head back. Exhale, come forward. As you come forward, try not to lose the squareness of the hips, keep the right hip back. If your heel starts to leave the ground, just walk the foot in closer. Inhale, reset the shoulders, exhale, rest your belly on your thigh, bend your right knee if you need to assist that movement. Now, keep on gliding your chest down as we're trying to get it beyond the knee. Inhale, come up halfway, bend the front knee, slide your left foot out and move the whole body to the right so that when you come forward again, your shoulder is not just resting on the knees, on the inside. Can try to take the forehead to the ground beside the foot. Sink through the hips, try to get them on the same line as the knee. Inhale, come up halfway, release the hands down on the mat. And again, spin on your feet so that your feet are parallel to one another. Hands are between the feet. And then bring your hands onto the hips and come all the way up. Press into your hips, into your legs. You can come up and then adjust your stance a little bit to make it more comfortable for you. The heels in, the toes pointing out. Take your hands to the seat. Pull down on the seat, push in at the same time. Inhale, lift through the chest. Exhale, if you feel comfortable, allow the head to go back. Keep using the hands to guide more legs in the lower back. Keep lifting your chest up away from the seat. Good. Another couple of breaths, roll the thighs outwards, roll the shins inwards, find the steadiness. Now push into the seat again, press into the corners of the edges of the feet to come all the way back up. And then turn forward again, and then bend into the front knee, and slide the feet back together. Hands to the heart, breathe in, breathe out, all fatigue. Good. So do a few other poses here. Inhale, reach the arms up over the head, reach back. Exhale, swan dive down. Lead with the heart, hinge at the hips, bring the hands down to the ground. Bend your knees again if you need to. So we're going to step back the right foot, lower the knee down, flatten up the toe. Inhale, come upright. Exhale, drop the seat all the way forward. Lift up through the chest. Exhale. You bring your hands to the seat. Pull down on the seat and use your fingers to press up so the rib basket lifts up. Bring the head back. Now use your hands like spacers. Try to pull the skin underneath the hands so that there's no wrinkles in the lower back. The skin is completely smooth. Bring the elbows back a little bit further as though you're trying to get them in touch. Inhale, coming back upright. Take the arms up, copy asana. Rock the shoulders back and forth a few times. Pull the arms behind the ears. And crescent moon. Make the body look like a crescent moon. Pull the body further back, the hips. Imagine the index fingers landing right over the back toe. Flatten out your body as much as possible.
heart to come back up. Good. Then we're going to place the hands down on the ground. Walk the left foot out a little bit. Good. From here, bend the toes under and just rock back and forth a few times. Try to get the feet to sink down. If your shoulder's lower than the knee, you might be able to bring the right forearm down and then the left. Inhale, telescope the chest forward. Exhale, again, drop down through the hips. Lower the back knee, flatten out the toe. Continue to just try to pull the seat towards the ground as you telescope the chest forward. Be very flexible. You try to get your chest to come right down onto the ground. Curl the left side of the seat under and make sure the knee's not falling away from the body. Bring the left foot out as much as you need to. Push back, and then come up. Move the left foot in so it's underneath the knee. Inhale, extend the arms out. Easy warrior two. And then easy triangle. Left hand down, the right arm up. Turn the chest towards the right arm comes up. Shoulder stays with the knee. I'll do it again in the other direction so you can see what it looks like from this side. Okay, if you want, bring the right arm behind the back, slip it in between the body and your thigh, and press the hand into the thigh. Alternatively, drop your shoulder down so it's a little bit below the leg. Left arm comes all the way around underneath, and you join the hands behind this, just beside the seat, behind the left thigh. Right shoulder moves back. Those of you who want to, who are flexible, can move left, weight into your left foot, bend the toes under, and lift the back knee up off the ground. Straighten out the right leg by raising the right hip. Keep the head low. You can keep your left knee bent if you need to. Keep just wrapping the back of the body around the leg, or feel as though you're trying to do this. Now release the hands, bring them down onto the ground, frame the front foot, lower the right knee down. Inhale, come upright, right arm comes up, chest and hips are square, right hand's the outside of the knee, left hand, bringing more length into the lower back. Lift up through the chest, exhale, turn to the left, look over your left shoulder. If that's easy for you, want to go into the other version, a deeper one, try to get the elbow to the outside of the thigh. Join the hands together, inhale, lift through the chest. Try to get your chest higher than the thigh, exhale. Keep on pressing into your hands so eventually the center of the chest comes in line with the thumbs. Left shoulder moves back. Now there's a way to get into the revolve triangle from here. You look down, bend the toes under the back foot, lift the knee, spin your feet. I'm sorry, I'm facing to face away from you, and then just trying to straighten out the right leg, and then again the head is low. Good, so from the other side it looks like this, so you can see it a little bit better. Actually no, that didn't help. Okay, so I have to stay at the same leg, bend the toes under, and then when you spin your feet are parallel, head is down, elbows to the outside still of the left leg. Good, break the pose, release the hand, the elbow, come back into your genuflect position. Good, plant the hands, and we're going to move the left foot back, the right foot forward. Lower the back knee down, flatten out the toe. Inhale, come upright. Exhale, drop the seat all the way forward. Take your hands to the seat for a moment and just can create space in the lower back by lifting the rib basket up away from the seat. Curl the tail under. Feel free to stay with your hands just as they are on your back, or you can lift back up. Take the arms up. Kapiasana. Stretch the arms, keep them close to the heads with the arms. Don't bend at the elbows, and reach back. Visualize a crescent moon in your mind, trying to make your body look like what you see in your mind.
Break the pose, inhale, lift through the chest, press into the front knee to come back upright, right heel is underneath the right knee. Arms out to the side, easy virabhadrasana, and then we're coming down. The right hand to the inside, the left, right foot, left arm up. If you did it fine the first time, go ahead again. Move the right shoulder down, and then left arm, right arm comes underneath the leg, left arm over the body, behind the body. Take the left shoulder back. Again, if you want to go into triangle, bend the toes under, lift the knee, and eventually try to get the right leg straight as well. But don't worry if it doesn't happen, just keep the shoulder with the knee and just work progressively. Release the hands down to the ground. Good, bring hands to the inside, right foot moves out into, bring the left knee down. Inhale, come upright, left arm up, go into the twist. Again, staying with the higher version of staying more upright, left hand to the outside of the right knee, right hand on the seat, pressing down and in, or moving into the deeper one, the elbow on the outside of the thigh. Your hands are by the shoulders, keep pushing into the hands until the chest comes up high enough to center behind the thumbs, and then roll the right shoulder back. Try to get the chest to look straight up. Again, if you want to go into the bound triangle, the revolved bound triangle, bend the toes under the back foot, lift the knee, spin on your feet so they're parallel to one another. Keep pushing the left elbow against the right thigh. Try to get the weight distribution even between both feet. Now break the pose. Release the hands back down, and then turn towards the front end of the mat. The right foot should be in front. Lizard. Rock back and forth a few times, trying to get the hips to come down. And then rest in the pose. Bring the knee down, flatten out the toes. Stay higher if you need to on your hands. Keep telescoping the chest forward or lower down. Onto the forearms, maybe even the chest comes down. Fix the gaze, just like the lizard. Try to imitate the form to the greatest extent possible. Then break the pose, come back onto the hands, and the knees back together. Draw the seat back onto the heels. Breathe in. Breathe out. From here, roll your way up. Move forward a little bit. Sukha Gomukhasana. Raise the right arm up. Keep the arm close to the head. And then you just bend your elbow so the hand comes behind the back. Bring the left hand up to the elbow and pull it up and push it back at the same time. So now the fingers are pressing roughly in the back of the heart, push into the heart and lift it up from behind. Inhale, lift up through the chest. Exhale, drop the shoulders, drop weight into the heels with your seat, but don't let the whole body fall back in to the hips. Keep upright, back straight. If you have the flexibility, left arm can come down, roll head and shoulder forward, and then sneak the hands up the back. Take the fingers into a finger lock. Inhale, push up through the chest. Lift up through the heart. Exhale again, descend the shoulders and the seat heavily. And release carefully. Shake out the shoulders a little. And then the left arm comes up.
right beside the ear. Bring the hand down the center of the back. Inhale, lift through the chest. Exhale, push the hand further, the elbow further back. Those of you who want to go into a bind, go ahead. Make sure that you're not moving into a place that brings pain to the body, and as a result, restlessness or anxiety to the mind. Inhale, keep lifting up through the heart, get taller, feel the navel hollowing out. Exhale, shoulders come down, the seat presses into the heels. And release, shake it out. Good, so we're going to bring our hands into table, make our way into downward facing dog. Shimmy your feet back a little bit. Now from here, we're going to come into a balanced pose. So bring the left foot forward, bend the knees, you can rest your chest on your thighs, and bring the arms back. This is hummingbird, so you're making the body as small as possible. Shift your weight forward, your head's coming to the ground, and if you can, bring all your weight into your left foot, and raise the right knee up towards the sky. Sink weight into your thigh with your body, keep your gaze intently on the ground in front. If you want to go to toppling tree, you would extend the right leg, and then take your hands into a bind, interlace the fingers. Pull the hands back, and then see if you can lift the chest a little bit. Oh, I'm not doing it very well this morning, I apologize. And then I'm on the mat where it's completely disjointed, so threw off my balance a little bit. Good. And then lift through the chest. Come down, bring the fingertips to the ground. Right foot comes back. Back into downward facing dog. Breathe in. Breathe out. Remove all struggles and all mental reactions or emotions that rose up. Try to keep the mind in the same calm temperament. We're moving on to the other foot now. Move the left foot forward halfway between the hands. Shift your weight forward and then bring the left knee up. Sometimes it's easier first to bring the leg up, rest your chest on your thighs. And then when you have the steadiness, take the arms back. Allow the weight of the body to rest on the right thigh. Feel free to stay here. Try to get your knee up higher, left knee. Or extend the leg, join the hands together, toppling tree. Pull the hands, keep pressing into your right foot, and bring your chest forward. Pose, left fingertips back to the ground, and right foot back, and left foot down, right foot comes back to join it. Breathe in, breathe out. Lower the knees down onto the ground, and come back. Sit on your heels, inhale, sit up tall, exhale, just sink weight into the heels. From here, we're just coming into a twist. So just take your legs out from underneath. Bend the left knee up. I'll do it this way so you can see. Bend the left knee, bring the left heel to the root. Lean to the left and fold the right leg back. Okay, so you try to have both sides of the seat grounded. If you need to pull the right foot out a little bit more or sit on something, so both sides even the sit bones are down, this is okay. If it's too much to do this, keep your right leg in front, left, and you just bring your toes in line to the knee if it's more comfortable. Okay, I'll go back to this pose. You can see, left arm comes up, the right arm just down the center of the back. Take the left hand to the outside of the right knee, or right thigh, inhale, lift through the chest. Exhale, turn to look behind you. keep the left, right arm propping the body up high so that the lower back stays lifted. If you want, you can lean forward a little bit, roll head and shoulder, and see if you can get your left hand to press into your left thigh, your right hand to press into your left thigh. Inhale, push your lower back in again, exhale, go deeper into the twist. One more breath, lift up through the lower back, exhale, turn. The twist starts at the hips and then the rest of the body eventually follows, like a helix type of motion, upward and further into the rotation. And then in the exhale, release, come back, lean to the left. Switch your legs around. Can move according to the condition of the body. Make sure left side stays grounded. Sit on something if you need to even it out. Left hand behind the back, just against the seat. Right hand to the outside of the left thigh. Inhale, lifting the chest. Exhale, turn to the left. If you want to snake your hand around further and press the hand into your right thigh, this is okay too. Lifting the chest, and as you twist, again the motion starts at the hips and eventually moves all the way up through the body. Make sure you ground through the left side of the seat if it starts to ride up. And return. Move. Lean to the right, so take your legs out in front, shake it out. Cross your ankles. Okay. So we're just going to come into rabbit pose. Bring the forehead in front of the knees, take hold of the heels, and lift the seat up so that you roll onto the top of the head. Try to lift the seat as much as you can. Push the belly button towards the back body. This is too easy. If you want something a little bit more, you place your hands down where you can see them in front of the head. So the arms are at right angles. Come forward and rest your shins against the knees. Come into teddy bear. You can keep your toes on the ground too if it's more comfortable. Bring more weight into the hands. Push down into the ground and you'll let you find a steadiness to stay up. In your pose, upside down. And we're going to come down, knees down, and roll your way up. Breathe in, breathe out. Swing your legs around again, lie on the back. Just have your feet close to the seat, knees pointing up, edges of feet in line with the hips. And when you bring your arms down beside the body, your fingers might just be able to touch the heels. Take a deep breath in first. Exhale, relax. Push into the arms, lift the seat up. And then tuck one shoulder at a time underneath so that the arms are underneath the body. Going more roundness into the upper part of the chest by trying to bring your chest close to your chin. The chest should look like a wall. And then use your hands, maybe bring them up to the hips and then tilt the hips forward a little bit so that the lower back again doesn't get all crunched up. And restrict it. Keep the back body free of wrinkles. Knees should be over the heels, back to knees in line with the heels, one straight line. More breath, try to get your chest even higher, even closer to the chin. And then lower down. Breathe in, breathe out. lift up the seats. You can bring your hands under the seats and then just sit on your hands. Bring your legs out. Inhale, lift the low upper body up. Walk the elbows a little bit closer. And then push into your hands and the elbows. Really press the chest up. Bring the head all the way down and back. Landing the top of the head on the ground. Fish pose. Keep your legs engaged and charged and together. Now breathe very fast like you're panting like a puppy, but do through the nose. Keep going with the breath. You want to raise your legs 12 inches. Go ahead. Lower the legs down. And then press into the lower arms. Release the head. Come back down. Breathe in. Breathe out all fatigue. Now raise the left knee up, bring it in towards the chest, and just press the thigh against the abdomen. The knees close to the shoulder. Keep holding on to the shin with your left hand. Right arm extends overhead and really pull the right heel forward. Raise the right arm up as high as you can so you can get as much distance between the hand and the foot. On the right side. Exhale, continue. Press the thigh into the left side of the body, the knees close to the shoulder. Try to feel the whole back really sinking into the ground. Every part of the back connected. One more breath, get long, and then take the hand to the outside of the right left knee. Pull the knee all the way over to the right. Point the right toes. Keep the back left shoulder on the mat. Extend the left arm out. Just in the line of the shoulder. And now, bring your attention to the lower back, the whole spine. And try to feel it lengthening. Curl the tail under. And just try to keep moving the left arm out so that the back of the shoulder stays flat. Back to center, left leg down, breathe in, breathe out. Now take the right knee up, same thing on this side. Use both hands first, press the shin into the shin with the hands, and try to get that right thigh to rest on the body. Make sure the right hip doesn't ride up, however. Roll the right hip down, left arm up. Now stretch to the left side as much as you can. Press out through the heel, press out through the fingers, tips, and squeeze the right knee against the shoulder, the thigh against the body. On the exhale. And then go into the twist, left hand comes the outside of the right knee, and then extend the right arm out. Again, to make sure that the top front of the right shoulder doesn't pop up, keep the chest flat and as wide as possible. Curl the tail under and just try to get the lower back, the whole spine, as long as possible. Exhale, return, roll onto your back, Shavasana. Allow your body to rest. Now, bring the feet to fall away from one another. The arms are resting on either side of the body. Hands beyond the edges of the mat, and just allow everything to soften, all the muscles, relax, limbs, arms, the trunk and the head, sinking into the ground below. Imagine just allowing it to fall and make an imprint into a bed of flowers or clouds or whatever you want to imagine. Yield to the softness. The more you relax, the more you surrender to that. The more you give yourself the ability to open yourself up to receiving all the gifts of the practice. Just imagine beams of light pouring into the body. And all these beams bring in the best of the best that the universe has to offer. All the energy and the love from all beings around you. Everything that you need to in order to feel fulfilled and connected with others. Just imagine you're everywhere, for in fact that's your true nature. For your true nature is love, which has no form. And it is boundless. Back from Shavasana. Start to become aware again of the breath, the fingers, the toes. Feel them starting to awaken. The limbs, the arms, the face. And the forces that animate the body as well. And in a deliberate, mindful, yet gentle way, prepare to come back from Shavasana and back into a seated position. Do so in a way that doesn't take away from any of the serenity that you just created through the practice, through the deep relaxation. Move gracefully, quietly. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Instill the peace within. Send it unto all. Om. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Be receptive to the divine grace within. Thank you so very much for coming.